In this essay, I will be analysing the use of character arcs and development in Netflix 2019 comedy drama Sex Education. I will be mentioning how characters such as Eric Effiong and Adam Groff change and develop throughout the 3 seasons using reference to Mittal 2015. Mittal mentions the anticipating ending looms over a series run with viewers waiting to judge a character's arc on morality, Mittal 2015, page 80. This means that the character's arcs and entice the audience and keep them watching. The character arc of Eric Effiong, played by Nkuti Gatwa, has developed significantly and becomes relatable, likable, and otherwise the type of people you would invite to your home each week, Mittal 2015, page 74. Eric was bullied for his sexuality and is at the bottom of the school hierarchy with his best friend Otis Milburn, played by Asa Butterfield. Eric's character arc, although not drastic, is still significant due to him discovering who he is throughout the serial. At the start of season one, Eric, although openly gay, still wants to fit in and it's a new school, so new people to impress. However, as the season goes on, he learns to accept that he needs to learn to love himself. Throughout season one, Eric's dad, played by Deobia Opori, doesn't accept Eric for who he is, causing Eric to not want to go to school events without feeling embarrassed. This can be described through Danan's having friends and family suggest to the gay characters to assume a gay identity that does not unsettle the heterosexual matrix. Danan's 2013, page 311. A key turning point in this is in season 1, episode 7, when Eric goes to church and the pastor mentions, "We must learn to love ourselves before we truly love others."
We must all learn to love ourselves before we truly love others.
This causes Eric to realize that he shouldn't hide who he is, therefore going to the school dance with heavy makeup, seen in Deyanin's Mock the Binary and Gender Appropriate Traditions, Deyanin's 2013, page 314. Eric's dad finally learns to accept Eric for who he is, which can be seen in this scene.
Are you sure you want to go in like this?
Yes.
Are you sure you're sure?
Yes. Why? What's wrong with it?
When I first came to this country, I had to do so much to fit in. I never wanted the same for my children.
Okay.
I wanted you to be proud, strong. But you are so different. It makes me feel scared for you.
Your fear doesn't help me, Dad. It makes me feel weak.
But why do you have to be so much?
This is me.
I don't want you to be hurt.
No, I'll be hurt either way. Isn't it better to be who I am?
Maybe. I am learning from my brave son.
The character of Adam Groff, played by Connor Swindles, has a drastic yet significant character arc and development. To start with, throughout the first season, he is known for being Eric's homophobic bully. However, at the start of the second season, Adam and Eric are fighting, which then turns to them sharing their first kiss. Despite this, Adam continues to give Eric mixed signals, therefore Adam's speech act of a silence, Sedgwick 1990, page 3, in Peters 2016, page 493. This can be seen in this season 3 scene.
What's wrong?
This isn't what I want.
You don't want to have sex with me.
Adam going from heterosexual to closeted is seen as a typical convention in a teen drama, described by Peters, for white middle to upper class male characters. A single same-sex sexual encounter triggers an immediate reclassification from heterosexual to closeted, Peters 2016, page 493. Adam and Eric's relationship becomes popular towards the audience throughout the episodes. Charisma largely stems from an actor's performance and physicality, but is also cued by how other characters treat their anti-heroes, where on-screen relationships cue viewers on how we should feel towards a character, Mittal 2015, page 76. This describes it clearly as Adam the anti-hero is disliked at the start of season 1 because of his treatment towards Eric, but the more we know about a character through revelations of backstory, relationships and interior thoughts, the more likely we will come to regard them as an ally, Mittal 2015, page 76. Therefore, as Adam becomes more and more vulnerable as the season goes on, the audience becomes more invested into their relationship and start to like Adam's character now they know more about him.
Please? Will you hold my hand?
Yes.
To explain, Adam's character arc goes from homophobic bully towards Eric to becoming closeted and dating Eric in secret, where he then tries wearing makeup for the first time, to then coming out to his friends and family in front of everyone. In my opinion, I believe Adam has the biggest character arc and development compared to the rest of the characters due to his sexuality, from being a bully to then dating the victim and being friends with the victim's friends, in this case Otis, highlights the change in personality. Therefore, he undergoes a change from sexual confusion to self-acceptance, Dayanin's 2013, page 309. In conclusion, the character arcs and developments explored through Adam and Eric are significant through the use of sexuality and homophobia.